Welcome. In this tutorial, we make decision using the expected opportunity loss approach and also describe its relationship with the expected monetary value and with the expected value of perfect information. We will be using this payoff table where payoffs are profits and the probabilities of the states of nature are 0.2, 0.5 and 0.3 respectively. To begin, we obtain a regret or an opportunity loss table. Regret is the difference between the best payoff in a particular state of nature and the actual payoff received. If the economy is growing, the best payoff is 70, so if we invested in bonds, the regret is 70 minus 40, which is 30. For stocks, it is 0. For mutual funds, it is 17. If the economy is stable, the best payoff is 45. If we invested in bonds, there is no regret. For stocks, the regret is 15. And for mutual funds, it is 0. For declining economy, the best payoff is 5. For bonds, there is no regret. For stocks, the regret is 18. And for mutual funds, the regret is 10. So here is the regret or opportunity loss table. To make decision using the expected opportunity loss approach, we calculate the weighted average of the regrets for each decision alternative. The weights are the probabilities of the different states of nature or outcomes. For bonds, the expected opportunity loss is calculated as 0.2 times 30 plus 0.5 times 0 plus 0.3 times 0, which equals 6. For stocks, the EOL is 0.2 times 0 plus 0.5 times 15 plus 0.3 times 18, which gives 12.9. For mutual funds, the EOL equals 6.4. Since these are expected regrets, the best will be the minimum. Therefore, we always make our decision by choosing the alternative with the minimum EOL. And that decision in this case is to invest in bonds. Now, it is important to note that the minimum EOL decision will always be the same as the maximum EMV decision. This is because EMV and EOL for every decision are kind of complements, and they always add up to the same value for every alternative. In this example, they add up to 38 for each alternative. Another interesting relationship is with EVPI. The expected value of perfect information is actually always the same as the minimum EOL. In an earlier video, we saw that the EVPI is 6, and so is the minimum EOL here. Note that if we have perfect information, then the expected regret or EOL is reduced to 0. In this example, we can say that with perfect information, the decision maker will reduce EOL by 6, and that's expected opportunity loss. Thanks for watching.